Hello, and thank you for tuning into this video series, which is part of E3's Online Learning Educator Series. This series was created to assist schools and teachers by providing different tools and strategies to make online learning successful for teachers and students. My name is Cecilia Portillo, and this is my colleague, Dr. Lawrence Kiju, and we are both part of E3's Deans of Instruction and Curriculum. The focus of our video series today is how to use online learning platforms, specifically UC Scout. So our agenda today is going to cover the platform of UC Scout. We're going to talk a little bit about the benefits of using UC Scout. We're going to look at how to set up UC Scout. What are some things for you to think about in advance? And what are some of the pitfalls you should consider prior to launching your UC Scout at your site? So with that being said, I'm going to hand it over to Dr. Zhu.
Hello, everyone. As educators, we are using a lot of different online learning platforms. Just to name a few, such as UC Scout, Ingenuity, Achieve 3000, iXL, and Node-RED Ink. When we are considering different online learning platforms, we are focusing on the following factors: whether it's a good virtual learning environment, whether the program is easy to use, whether it's safe to use for our students, and whether the content can be customized based on the student's achievement background, as well as the teacher's needs. And most importantly, whether the quality of content delivery is clear.
So what is UC Scout? UC Scout is a program developed by the University of California, and it delivers A through G approved online classes and curriculum to students around the globe. The course materials are designed to inspire lifelong curiosity and prepare all of pupils from all backgrounds and education levels for an increasingly technological world where training and job skills are mobile, asynchronous, and self-directed. It is also a free platform for California public schools and teachers.
Different online learning platforms provide different benefits. When we are using UC Scout, we notice the following benefits. First, we can use certain UC Scout courses as the core curriculum, such as AP Spanish language and composition. We also use some UC Scout courses for students who want to accelerate in certain subjects. For example, a student currently enrolled in Math 2 in a regular class can be enrolled in UC Scout Math 3 course simultaneously. Also, we want to use UC Scout for courses we didn't offer due to enrollment number. For example, we have one student who wants to take the AP US government and politics. Instead of creating a physical class, we enrolled the students in the UC Scout course.
So how do we set up a UC Scout account? So in order to set up a UC Scout account for your class, you must either have a certificated teacher in the specific area or pay UC Scout for a certificated teacher. Then the teacher must register with UC Scout. You will be provided with enrollment information for each one of your students. Students can then enroll into the course under your assigned course. Students will then have access to see the dashboard, which contains videos, lessons, and additional materials needed for the course. You can additionally add your own course materials if you want to supplement any of the additional materials UC Scout has provided.
Here are a few things you may want to consider before start to use UC Scout. You want to streamline the curriculum vertically by different grade level. You want to expand teaching and learning model a little bit beyond the traditional classroom instructional model. Also, you want to provide additional courses that were not in the original master schedule. Also, beforehand, consider to train your teachers, although the system is fairly easy to use. Lastly, teachers need to understand and to be trained for understanding and analyzing individual student data in the system so they can use data-driven strategy to provide close support to the students.
So what are some of the pitfalls that can be avoided? So when registering your students, they need to use their full legal name. And then what we would recommend is that you have them write that username down, because what tends to happen is they will enter their usernames with nicknames and then they forget, and then they can't access their course. So make sure that you have them write it down, and make sure that they use their full legal name, because that also comes up for you when you're using the teacher dashboard. And so when you're grading them or when you're looking to see what they've completed and you see a nickname, well, you won't be able to quickly identify what student needs that support. Second, it's very important to model for students how to use the platform. So especially in this distance learning environment, using the technology, for example, Zoom, being able to share your screen and walking them through the different components of the Canvas infrastructure and how to look at the different modules and what they contain is very important for all of your students to understand, especially if you have students that are second language learners. And you also should avoid just opening up all of the modules for your students. What we recommend and what we've learned through the process is that when you start to mentor the students, you start to open up those individual modules and you teach them how to do those goal settings and you keep them on a pace. So you give them, you know, a set time for them to complete a certain module. And then as they start to progress, you start to open up different modules, and then they can start to advance at their own pace, but always checking in with them to make sure that they're not falling behind and consistently moving them along, helping them set realistic goals so that they don't fall behind.
I hope the information Ms. Patil and I shared with you today are helpful to you. With the current challenging situation forcing most schools to go distance learning, it's the best time to explore and take advantage of the platform that UC Scout provides. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you very much, and we hope you have a wonderful journey through UC Scout.